Okay, this is Motional EMFs, unit one. We have a square coil, a square wire being pulled out of a constant magnetic field that is into the board with a magnitude of 7 tesla. There's a resistor in the circuit of 2 ohms. He's pulling with a force F, and we are going to be asked to find that force. The velocity, it's pulling at a constant velocity of 3 meters per second, and we're given the dimensions of the overall dimensions of the coil is 0.75 in length and 0.5 meters in width here, right? So the first thing we're asked to find is the magnitude of the induced EMF. Well, we know that the magnitude of the EMF is given by the time rate of change of the magnetic flux. So we write this down. And the magnetic flux is equal to B times A, the effective area, right? Well, the magnetic field is constant at 7 tesla. We were told that in the beginning, so that factors out of the derivative. And we have that the EMF is just equal to B, which is going to be 7, times dA dt. But it's the effective area. It's not the total area. Because as this thing moves out, less and less of this magnetic field is encompassed, right? So the area of this thing is equal to L effective times the width, right? And then dA dt, right, because this L effective becomes less and less and less and less and less as this moves as the coil is being pulled out, right? So this is, the width is constant though. Look, as this part of the coil gets pulled towards the barrier, towards the horizon of no magnetic field, it's the same value all the time. It doesn't change, right? So that's a constant, so it's W times dL effective dt. Well, how fast that effective length is changing, that's just the velocity. That is what the velocity is. So this is W times V. So dA dt is equal to WV, the time derivative of the area is W times the velocity. So BWV. Plug the values in, 7 for the width, we get 0.5, the velocity is 3. We do this, and it is 21, half of 21, 10.5 volts. For part B, we're asked, what is the magnitude of the current and what is its direction? So we use Ohm's law, epsilon equals IR, right? The electromotive force is equal to I times R, and I is equal to epsilon over R, which is equal to, yep, the thing we just found, 10.5. divided by the resistance, which is 2. So this number is 5.25 amps. And finally, the current. We are asked to find, well, we're not done with part B. We need to find its direction. Okay, so Lenz's law. Here we go. So this thing is moving. This thing is moving over to the right, okay? So even though the magnetic field is into the board, remember we defined in our previous units for Lenz's law, previous videos, we defined the delta phi vector, right? So this magnetic field over the area has a flux, and that flux has a direction. It's into the board, right? So as this side of the wire moves this way, it's big initially, the total area is big, but that magnetic field flux vector gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So even though it's pointing into the board, it's getting smaller. So it's changing in that direction. So delta phi, is out of the board like that. So we take our thumb and we point it in the direction, the opposite direction of delta phi, right? Because the flux is changing out of the board. We want to induce current that opposes that change in flux, right? So we point our thumb opposite that and our fingers curl in the direction of the induced current, which will be clockwise. Now we go to part C. Part C says, what is the force required to pull this thing out at constant velocity of 3 meters per second, x hat? Okay, so x hat just meaning to the right, okay? So, well, now that there's an EMF and there's a current in these wires, we know from previously that a current moving through a wire, if current is in a wire and that wire is moving through a magnetic field, there's going to be a force on it, right? So there's a force on this segment here, this segment, and this segment. So we need to consider all three separately. I'm going to give ourselves a little room here. I'm going to draw a real crude picture. The current is this way, I. So the force on the wire will be equal to I cross B, where I is the current vector, where I is equal to the length of the wire times the magnitude of the current in the direction of the current, which I annotate by I hat. So for the x, y, z directions, instead of using I, j, k, we use x hat, y hat, z hat, and that frees up the I, j, k, and we'll use I hat for the direction of the current. I think it's easier to think about it in this way. I think you'll find so also. So for this segment, we put our fingers in the direction of the current vector, right? We sweep them into the magnetic field, which is into the board, and our thumb points down. So the force on this segment here is down, right? And then let's look at this one. The current is like this. Current vector is up. We sweep it into the magnetic field vector that is in the board, and the thumb is off to the left, so the force is off like that, and this has a vector on top of it also. Okay. Now let's do the top. The current vector is coming back this way. So we sweep it, we put our fingers in the direction of the first vector, which is the current vector, we sweep it into the B field, into the board, and our thumb points up. And the force is up like that, right? So we see right away that these two, this force and this force, cancel one another because they're equal and opposite and they're always in the same magnitude, right? ILB. So those forces cancel. So the only force of concern is this one over here, right? Now, when will this thing be able to be pulled at constant velocity? Well, it's pulled at constant velocity. Remember, a body is static whenever it's either at rest or moving with constant velocity. So if it's moving at constant velocity, the acceleration is equal to zero, right? So that means there's two forces, the man pulling and the magnetic force pulling back to the other direction. Those two forces have to be equal. So we have the force on the man must be equal to the force due to the current. And we can label this F sub I, if we like. And that is simply equal to the current vector, right? The magnitude of the current vector is just Li. So LIB, and that is X hat because the man is pulling that way, opposite the direction of the current. In fact, if you want to be completely neurotic about the directions, you put a little negative sign there. But whatever. And then it turns back into a positive whenever you put X hat, because X hat is the correct direction. Okay? So, the length that we're concerned with, this is the length that's not changing, right? So, this is 0.5 meters, the length of the wire of concern. 0.5 times the current value we found to be 5.25. The magnetic field value is 7. And this one I'm not going to do in my head. This one is 18.4 newtons. And it's right. Which is the same as X hat, right? And that is about 4 pounds. For those who are interested. And in terms of significant figures, four pounds. Right. Okay. That is motional EMFs, right? So I'm going to step out of the way, give you a clear screenshot. Try this one yourself. Study it, learn it, try it yourself. But do it with a blank page and don't cheat yourself, okay? Because you want to be able to start with a blank page on the exam and go all the way to the end. All right, I'm going to go.